Hi, I'm George Pearson, and I'm going to show you how you can use Photoshop Elements to remove text from a picture. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to share. Also, don't forget to subscribe. I do several videos every single week. And also, take a look at my complete training courses for Photoshop Elements, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. It's actually possible to remove text from a photograph using Photoshop Elements, and I'll show you a way to do that right now. Let's just dock this picture in here. There we go. And let's zoom this back to fit screen. Now I have two pictures here. Notice that everything here is on just one layer. This is just a JPEG picture. There we go, .jpg. And it has text on here. In this case, it's solid text. Doesn't matter what the color is, as long as it's different from your background color, which of course it will be so you can see it. So, solid text, I also have one here with transparent text. You can kind of see through that text. Same technique, a little bit more difficult here with the transparent text. So we'll start off here, and I'm going to zoom in so we can see our text. Now, this is fairly easy to do. The bigger and bolder your text is, the easier this is. If you have real small text, it gets a bit more difficult, but the same basic principle applies. We'll start off by grabbing the magic wand over here. And make sure you're set at new. I have my tolerance at 25. Any low number should work out okay for this one. And then just click inside of a letter. Make sure then you change over here to where it says add. And then click inside of each one of your letters as well. Now notice that it's just choosing just that letter and not everything. That's because I have contiguous checked right down here. So if that's not checked, make sure you have that checked as well. And we'll just continue on and select all of these letters, all these pieces. Again, this is pretty easy if the letter is solid like this. I now want to expand this selection just a little bit into the background so it's not right up against those letters. And you can do that with the select menu right here, and then come down to modify and expand. I have mine set at 1 pixel, and in most cases, that's all you need. Just go ahead and choose OK. And notice how the selection is just a little bit larger than it was before. It's just a little ways out into the background and away from the lettering. Okay, now at this point, just in case, we'll be changing this picture. So I would make a copy of your background here. Just right click and choose Duplicate Layer. And we'll do our fix on the duplicated layer and leave our background untouched. Okay, so on our duplicated layer, go up to Edit, come down to Fill Selection, and Content Aware, and it's right there. You'll see this if you have a selection made. Then choose OK, and let Photoshop Elements figure it out, and there we go. Actually looks just about perfect on this. Let's just deselect that, and there it is. You really can't see where those letters were. Maybe a little bit right in here, could use a little bit of a touch-up, and right here there's a little bit, could use a touch-up. Let's just take a look at that. There's our before, there's our after. Let's go ahead and fix those two little spots. I'll just use the clone stamp tool over here, and that's a 31 pixel. That's pretty good size. It's a soft edge. Hold the Alt key down to choose where you want to clone from, and click your image, and then roll over and then just come in and clone on top of where you want to fix, and that fixes that. This one in here, I'm going to go for a smaller brush on this. All I want to do is pull some of this brown down into that area there. So I'll just grab right here, and I'll just come right here and just a little bit, just like that, just kind of connects that little bit. That looks better. Maybe right in here, I'll just pull this line down just a little bit, and I'll pull this up just a little bit. And that looks good. Okay, I think that's a pretty good fix on that. Let's go back to fit on screen. And that's a successful repair right over there. Maybe looking at it again, maybe there's a little bit of this pink coloration showing in here from out there. So as you can see, it's not a perfect technique and will need a little bit of touch-up. But in most cases, a little bit of work with the clone stamp tool is really all you're going to need to do a final cleanup, and everything will look great. Just a little bit of touch-ups in here, get rid of some of that stuff, and then just about there. OK, Okay, I think that's good. Okay, back to fit screen. There it is. That's a successful fix. So there is the original, and there it is with that fix on it. Okay, pretty straightforward. Let's now take a look at the one with the text that is a bit transparent. Now, just like last time, we want a new copy of this layer, so right-click and duplicate layer, choose OK, there it is. Okay, let's go ahead now and we'll zoom in on this lettering. And you can see it's see-through, has a transparency to it, or seeing the image through that lettering. This makes it more difficult. Not impossible, but it is more difficult. Go back to the magic wand. Again, I have mine set at 25 right now. It's just kind of a standard number. At the new selection over here, it's at contiguous, and let's begin working these in. Click on your first one, then switch over to add right there, and then click in your next letters. Now we get in here where it is overlapping some changed spaces, and this is not going to select the whole thing, as you can see here. It will just take several click-throughs to get all those pieces, just like that. As long as this works, we're okay, and it won't take anything else. Now in here, it's a little bit too much down there. That's not important. It's a real small amount. When I click in here, all of a sudden it began giving me a lot of excess stuff I didn't want selected. So let's go ahead and undo that one step. And let's bring our tolerance level down. I'll bring it down to 10. And let's try it at 10. Okay, that worked better. So now just come here and finish off your selection. There we go. If there's any little bits inside, make sure you catch those. A little hard to see there, but make sure you catch those. A little bit off like this, again, does not matter. And let's go ahead and finish off our lettering. I think we'll be okay at this point. Everything else looks pretty straightforward. And just several clicks with your magic wand to select the whole letter. And those little inside pieces, make sure you catch those in that corner right there. Okay, so again, all of our letters are selected just like before. We're now going to expand this selection. So back up to select, come back down to modify and expand. And again, I have mine set at 1 pixel, choose OK. Just a little bit larger, so it's just selecting a little bit of the background in there. And back up to edit, come down to fill selection, content aware, and choose OK. Let's deselect and see how we did. And again, that looks real nice. Maybe a little bit of touch-up needed in here, a little bit of touch-up in there. Let's go ahead and take care of that. Again, I'll be using the clone stamp tool for this. Hold the Alt key down to choose your clone from spot, and then just clone that in. I like working left to right, especially on this kind of a gradient. It's important that you go directly left to right. Up in here, it's kind of free-form. I'll just grab from wherever and just bring in some stuff to cover up those spots. There we go, just about done. A little bit in here and right there. And that's fixed. Maybe a little bit weird in here. Let's go ahead and I'll grab some of this, bring that down. Grab some of this and bring that up. Meets in the middle. And this little bit right here again. And that's just about good. Okay, there we go. Let's now go back to fit screen, and there it is. And again, looks real clean. Let's take a look at that. There's the before with the see-through letters, and there is the fix. So it's really all there is to it. The larger your letters are, the easier this is going to be. This is a pretty good sized letter. And it's not too big. If your letters are as big as a picture, it's not going to work. You can't put in that kind of missing information. But this is a pretty easy size to work with. If your letters are smaller, it's just going to be more difficult to make your selections, but not a big deal. If the lettering is too much larger than this, it may get a bit more difficult because it's harder to find enough background to fill in. That's not going to show. Also, if your lettering is on top of something really critical, like if it was up in here, it'd be very difficult for this technique to work perfectly. It may take a bit more work with the clone stamp tool to get a nice invisible repair. So just keep those in mind. It's going to depend upon the size of your letters how much they're see-through or not. If they have any variations in the letters, it makes it more difficult. And also the background that it's sitting on. But this is a pretty good technique and will work most of the time. So there you go. That's how you can remove lettering from a photograph using Photoshop Elements. Don't forget to check out my training courses for Photoshop Elements. I have different versions for each version of Photoshop Elements, including a brand new one for Photoshop Elements 2020. And there's links for that right down there in the description. Also, don't forget to hit like if you enjoyed this video. Click on share and subscribe so you won't miss out on any videos in the future.